Chris, but then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go then to Bob, and I'm going to go, Bob, I want to make this fight, right?
Bob said it's okay.
But if he doesn't want to pay for it, I'll pay for it.
Exactly.
There you go.
So you win. You win twice. Yeah. You win three times, you know? And I wouldn't have no say so.
Hold on, wait. I got to step in, though.
Get in the middle, Tio.
I got to step
in.
No, I'm staying right here.
But ESPN will fight for it, too.
I can have it. I'm on ESPN. I do on both.
In association with ESPN. I like it.
If it's the right deal for everybody, we can do it on ESPN.
Everybody's gonna
win.
We can
put it on both. And if Bob don't want to pay for it, I'll pay for it.
It's
a pleasure to have you on the zone.
You a man of the world. Have I only talked good things about this guy the whole interview?
Yes.
But that
has
been an honor that he's a gentleman the whole time.
But because at the end of the day, you gotta look at it too.
I'll say this, and while we're giving each other compliments, I want to say this. I was looking at your son in the ring earlier, and I thought to myself, that's the guy that beat Lomachenko, right? I feel like he should get a lot more praise for what he did.
Course.
Because
course.
When he beat Richard Comey, and they said, yeah, he's going to fight Lomachenko. I said, yeah, Lomachenko. What a stupid decision. Because this kid's a star. He's just had a great win at MSG. They should build him. They should have a couple of defenses and make that fight even bigger. Yet you had the balls to go and fight Lomachenko.
And get the lesser price.
And probably take not as much money as you should have done.
Yeah.
Man, I went home with like $600,000 that fucking night.
My heart bleeds.
The whole world doesn't need to know that.
My heart bleeds.
And I live off of a fucking budget, but I love it. You know why? Because that's how the billionaires do it. So I'm actually
thankful, always live poor.
Yeah, you got to live poor. Yeah. But that's why I work my butt off over here. Because I know eventually
that
will
come.
What
I'm saying to you is you should have been the star of ESPN.
Of course,
after that performance, for what you achieved, you should be a superstar.
I'll say like this though, like everything connects in this way. He's a businessman, he knows what he wants and what he's doing, matchroom boxing, he holds that, right?
Yeah.
Takeover Promotions is coming in, right? So all the things like, we'll talk in 2 years after my ESPN deal.
The one thing I'll tell you about Takeover Promotions,
which
is the same thing I'll tell you about Devin Haney Promotions. And the same thing I'll tell you about Canelo Promotions is all these promotional companies, the one thing they don't want to do is take any risk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because this is what bigger promoters do.
Of course.
And it's a tough business.
He's talking about rematch clause.
No, I'm not talking about that.
I'm talking about
the risk that is on the show.
Yes.
So as I always say to Bill and Devin, so if this show loses $1 million and you're my co-promoter, are you in for half?
But you got to.
But I want to ask you a question.
I say like this though. Investing, you have to, in order to invest, you have to lose first before you gain anything.
My advice to you.
I invested in myself.
Yeah,
I took whatever
that,
I had to
don't,
take.
Don't invest.
But I'm not going to take.
Don't
no, I'm not
going to
shows. Okay.
Let the promoters lose the money.
Of course.
Make sure you get the right deal. That's
yes,
all.
Of course. I am. I mean, I get 70% net.
We don't got to tell nobody, bro.
Hey, no, but it's all good.
But anyway, I got to say something, and it's something that I loved about what Eddie said. Who's the boss?
Yeah.
Who's the boss?
You're the boss. Well, not you.
Not me. Him.
He's the boss.
Okay.
This is what I
the
say.
Fighters are the boss.
The older generation, and even my dad included.
You sure your dad ain't going to kill you?
No, it's fine. Because he said it before. They come from an era where the fighters work for the promoter. That don't exist. We work for the fighters. It doesn't matter whether it's a 6-round fight for someone turning professional. They're my boss. I work for them. But that generation can't say it. If you said to Bob, tell me, Bob, look into my eyes and tell me that Teofimo Lopez is your boss, do you think he could say it?
No.
He couldn't say that.
I don't think so.
But I'll tell you this.
No comment.
On November, everyone watch this on camera? On November the 27th, at Madison Square Garden on the zone, Teofimo Lopez is my boss.
Can you look at him and say he's undisputed?
No.
That's it.
We won't do that yet.
Wow. Yeah, but the fight is promoted as undisputed. Everybody knows
I'll tell you, as I said.
The fight is promoted as undisputed.
November 27th, I work for him. No shame in that.
I'm just
a promoter. He's the fighter.
And then
star.
February 2.
Because at the end
February.
Of the day, at least someone understands it, is this. He can't eat without the fighters. We can't eat without the promoters.
Exactly.
You can always eat because you're the talent. Doesn't matter who.
Thank you. That's true what he says. That's true what he says. Yeah. But he's talking about platform wise.
Yeah, but I promise you this: to make this happen, we ain't gonna be making a load of money on November 27th. But we get to promote Teofimo
Lopez. Wait, chill. Check the viewership.
You can't lie to us about the viewership. No, please.
But that's good for this.
Because I want to chill. I want to shut up TFT.
I want to make this happen. So I don't care about making money on this show. I want to be involved in the fight. I want to work with you guys. I want to bring you to design. Job done for me. All right? So the rest is up to you.
Hey, Eddie. Give him my interview back.
The girl that you saw working earlier.
Yeah.
Tia works with all the kids.
Yes.
That's what we do. We give
back.
And
no fighter steps up except Caleb Plant and Teofimo Lopez.
As you know.
Steps up to the plate.
As you know, boxing changes lives.
Yes, it does.
It saves lives.
Changes
a lot of lives.
Yeah. And, you know, you see another example of that girl where boxing has saved her life.
Yes.
Really.
Yes.
So whether it's an opportunity to become a professional or just to get some discipline and structure and respect in your life, boxing has the opportunity to do that.
And I mean,
but not enough
like
people
you
see
to
that.
Put a fair game into it so everybody gets a chance, just a few.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I want to thank everybody for coming, and I just want to say it's a blessing to be with the zone.
One more question for my interview,
you know,
with you. So this happened.
I mean, I just want to thank everybody, and I want to tell Eddie, we got to see the numbers, Eddie, because a lot of people talking a lot of shit that we don't do numbers, we don't put asses in the seats. We got to stop that already. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, they got bigger people that have been in the game for long, and because they say that, people believe it. You know what I'm saying? But come, I mean, we did 4.2 million views on ESPN with the Lomachenko fight. And everybody knows that about that, you know. So I just want to put that out in the clear. We want to see the numbers that night.
Mr. ESPN over there, Mike Coppinger as well.
There you go.
So, what, the prick?
The prick. See, I've got one more question just about
the deal.
You want Josh Taylor to fight, obviously he's fighting the Sabre.
No, I'm glad I got my name.